with Mental Fitness Matters. This show is designed to provide people with tips, strategies, and solutions to improve your mental fitness. This is Mental Fitness Matters. Hey, hey, everybody. Happy Thursday. You are listening to Mental Fitness Matters. I am your host, Tracy Austin, and this is WSIC Radio. Happy Thursday. I hope everyone out here is having a great week. Today's show is going to be so much fun, and it's going to fly by, so I'm going to get right to it because I have the honor of having my friend, a living legend in the building with me today, Jack Grossman. If you have tuned into this show before, you know I am always very curious about people's stories, but also how they take care of their mental health and their mental fitness, because I think it's an important piece of who we all are. So I cannot wait to introduce you guys to Jack and for him to share his story of persistence and perseverance. Also, his transformational experience with cold water therapy at Wilder Wellness Center in Mooresville, North Carolina. So I'm going to go ahead and introduce Jack. He is an entrepreneur and author. He has written and designed award-winning advertising, has won numerous prestigious awards for regional and national clients. He has also published an award-winning lifestyle magazine. Jack's fundraising efforts have raised over $18 million in cash and in-kind for numerous nonprofit organizations. He was the recipient of the Mooresville-South Iredell Chamber of Commerce Citizen of the Year Award in 2018. Jack is the author of Child of the Forest, along with co-author James Buchanan, a true story about a young girl and her experiences following a Nazi invasion of her small town in eastern Poland. The book has garnered tremendous recognition and has won two best nonfiction awards internationally, as well as best cover design and other awards. This book is in the early development stage for an episodic series. Welcome to the show, Jack.
Tracy, it's always nice to see you and be with you.
My goodness, it's always so good to catch up, and I am so excited that you are here. Tell the people more about who you are, my friend.
Well, first of all, Melissa and Patrick's show was incredible, and they tell you in public speaking, never follow children. Right. So here I am. They were incredible, very inspiring.
Way to get the energy rolling in this room.
Oh,
huh?
Goodness. Yes, absolutely. So my family, my wife and three daughters, we moved up here in 2000, kind of get away from Florida for a little while and experience maybe a little bit of all four seasons. We just didn't know you would experience them all in the same week,
right?
But here we are. We love it. I've been involved in nonprofit work. I guess now it's for 40-plus years.
Wow.
I used to say 35-plus, but the 5 years, you know, have gone by so fast. So pretty incredible. I was involved in instrumental in building a Boys and Girls Club in Florida. And then, of course, as you all know, Dove House Children's Advocacy Center right here in Statesville.
You have been coined the house that Jack built for the Dove House.
Yeah, I've heard that a few times. That's great. There's a tile when you walk in that someone purchased with that little quote on it.
I love it. I love it. So let's get into it, my friend. You know, this show, we always try to talk about what mental fitness kind of means to the individuals that come on. You have a really incredible story. You're an author of a book that we're going to talk about. It's really having the chance to go on national here, right?
Yes.
But tell us first, before we get into that, a little bit about who you are, what mental fitness means to you, and walk us through how you kind of stumbled upon this cold water therapy experience. I'm excited to hear about
that's
this.
That's pretty cool. Well, I've always been a very driven person and have always sought out personal growth opportunities, going to seminars, reading books, and really expanding my mind that way. I've spoken in front of 10,000 people twice. You can check that one off the list of most feared items for a lot of people.
Yeah.
I've been through a lot of challenges. I had a near-death stroke in 2010 that almost took me out.
Got it.
It was pretty major. Like I said, I did a lot of public speaking, and I would say that it was a brainstem stroke, which, you know, is like the control center. It affects your breathing, your heart rate, your vision.
Yeah.
And right there's three things I enjoy every single day.
Yeah.
So I was close. It was a close call. I'm here, and mental fitness to me means running on all cylinders. I mean, really putting the mind, the body, the spirit all together in one package and running smoothly, and being able to face your fears and your challenges, which I've always felt like I had a decent approach towards that, but the cold water therapy really put it into high gear.
Yeah, I bet it did. Let's talk about that. How did you stumble? Yeah. So is that one of the ways you decided to say, you know what, I'm going to take care of my mind and body through that? Was it after your near-death experience that led you into finding?
It was more recent. It was at Ammo Cafe where you and Melissa and I like to hang out and solve the world problems. Yeah, have a great cup of coffee. Try the Jack special. And I overheard a couple of friends talking, and that's happened in there so many times. It's like my office away from home, so I'm in there practically every day. And, I heard a friend talking about, his cold water therapy and how he left a traditional practice of, as a therapist he had for 15 years to get into this. And I thought, wow, you must believe in it if you're going to walk away from a career like that. And so we sat and we chatted for probably a couple hours. I asked a lot of questions, as I like to do when I meet someone, and kind of play detective and listen really well. And I was just blown away. I don't know that cold water was on my list of things I feared most, but I knew that it would be a tremendous challenge.
Yeah.
So immersion in ice water for minutes. So I signed up with Bill and went through the program, and it was incredible, absolutely life-altering.
Wow. So you were in cold water. So if I'm not mistaken, cold water or hydrotherapy, it's what, 59 degrees?
I think in the low 50s, somewhere in the low 50s. And I blew myself away because I couldn't believe that I lasted 6 minutes in the water, which may not sound like a long time, but and I had a friend who followed after me, who I talked to about the program, and she went for it, and she was 10 minutes in the ice water, man.
What was that process like? Did you have to work yourself up to? So some of the benefits when we talk about cold water therapy and what the benefits for mental health, the brain, having to get control of your breathing, some of that Wim Hof breathing.
Absolutely.
So what
the
was
ice
that?
Man.
The Iceman.
Yeah.
What was that process like? Did you have to work yourself up to 6 minutes?
I just did a one-day program.
Got
so
it.
These retreats can go up to 3, 4, 5 days and more.
Got
so
it.
Mine was kind of condensed, but we started with the assessment. Bill's got these amazing giant charts in a room, and you kind of go through and look at what your barriers are, what is it that you want to change in your life, and it's a series of these assessment charts. Then following that, we got into some deep breathing exercises, which once again, I was kind of blown away that I was able to, after the exercises, hold my breath for a minute. Now, that doesn't sound like a long time either, but following my stroke and not being very active, and I thought that was a long time. It was pretty impressive to myself anyway. So following that process, then we did a cold water immersion, and followed by hot water, which didn't get ruined, but it was interesting. I didn't know what to expect. So after the 6 minutes, which was incredible, and Bill was awesome because of my stroke, I needed help getting in and out of the hot tub because it's elevated and you gotta step up. He made sure, took great care so that I wouldn't slip or fall. My fear being that I'd slide under the water and might take a little while to get me back out.
Yeah.
But it was great, wonderful. He did a great job. And then immediately going into the hot water, and I'm just starting to enjoy it, and he walks up with this giant block of ice and hands it to me and says, here, lay that on your stomach and, watch it, experience it dissolving and going away, and kind of visualize those are the things that you want removed, and those are the barriers and the blockades. Also, once again, very powerful.
Wow.
And then a meditative therapy session, that's what I call it. I don't know what the exact name is, with Esha, and she's like a spiritual counselor that was wonderful. It was like a meditative state of therapy, and she was very intuitive, brought some things out from years and years and years ago, even childhood type stuff, and worked through that. It was just wonderful. And then did another cold water immersion after that. I only lasted 5 minutes on the second one.
Wow.
Not sure why the minute less, but it was an incredible experience.
Talk about pushing your mind and body to limits and really stepping out and coming into some things that you connected with for yourself personally. I got to check that place out. So tell us, that's the Wilder Wellness Center. That's actually located in Mooresville, North Carolina.
It sure is.
They do retreats and programs like that. I'm coming to see you, Bill. I'm coming to check
awesome.
That out.
Awesome. You will absolutely love it. Wilder, W-I-L-D-E-R, Wellness, W-E-L-L-N-E-S-S, Center, C-E-N-T-E-R.com. Please go to the website because
cool.
Bill is running a summer special now that I'm telling you. These retreats and these one-on-ones can get into the thousands of dollars and they're worth every single penny. But let me tell you, he's got some stuff going on this summer for $50 a person in a group session, and you'll have an opportunity to experience this immersion. So highly, highly recommend it, and check it out.
Yeah.
And I want to see how you do.
Yeah, I'm going to have to take our team there. That sounds like a really good idea and experience, because I'm always looking for ways to optimize our health. Our overall mental and physical fitness, and really looking into alternative ways to kind of take care of yourself. It's necessary. So thank you for sharing that experience.
And there were some measurable benefits,
immediate
and some, you know, progressive. But I had suffered from sciatic pain for about 2 months or more prior to that session and did not expect and didn't know why. But as soon as I got out of that cold tub, it was gone and has been gone, and it's incredible as a side benefit. You know, I'm looking at the mental, but obviously had some sort of effect. But I kind of called it as I used to wake up in the morning and always say, face your fears. Mm. Now I say, plow through your fears. You know, it's like the Michael Jordan quote, if you got a wall in front of you, you can try to go around it and try to go under it or over it, but just plow through it, go through it.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what this process does in my mind. It allows you to tackle that, focus on solutions and not on problems,
mm-hmm.
which a lot of people get hung up on the problem. And, you know, if you keep repeating that on a daily basis, that's what you're going to get, in my opinion. I believe in the law of attraction.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's going to be, you know, speed bumps.
Yep.
Everybody's got them, right?
Absolutely.
I say, you know, when the bugs hit the windshield, spray the bug juice, hit the wipers, and keep going, right? And rip the rearview mirror off, because you're not going that way.
That's right.
Eyes straight ahead. So it was a great process, and encourage everyone to check out the website.
Well, thank you for sharing your experience of that. And speaking about keep going, so I want to kind of get into your book, Child of the Forest, and talk us through, because you had to kind of keep going, because I think 2010, when you had the stroke, you were in the process of writing and doing a lot of work there. So let's talk a little bit about.
Well, I met Charlene in 2006. So that's 15 years ago, Memorial Day, I met her. So when the kids in here earlier were talking about perseverance and keep going, and I can, let me tell you, do it.
Yeah.
All right. And that takes a tremendous amount of focus and perseverance, but you can do it. I think everyone's got a spark inside of them.
Absolutely.
And if you can fan that flame, you can do anything you put your mind to. Dove House is a good example. You know, there's a $2.2 million facility with no mortgage. You know, that doesn't just happen.
Exactly.
You got to put your mind to it. But so the book process, when I met Charlene in 2006, initially was going to be a film project. So that came way ahead of the book. And 2008, the economic meltdown. 2010, my stroke knocked me out for almost a couple years. I couldn't work. I went into survival mode. It was very difficult. I had to learn how to walk again, which is not something you expect to do all of a sudden. That was a challenge, very difficult. 2013, Charlene passed away. Another very tough time.
Mm-hmm.
And more recently, COVID. I had an incredible month of April set up about a year ago with, speaking at the Atlanta Country Club, a couple hundred people, Davidson College, a synagogue in Charleston, very prominent synagogue there, Woodlawn Day School. I mean, I was booked for the whole month, and in 1 second it all went away.
Mm-hmm.
So you could just raise the white flag and quit and surrender. But after already doing this for so many years, like I said, since 2006, it was just time to bear down. And it was during that process that I thought of an episodic series versus a film. So the book came out in 2018, and in a film, you got a couple hours to tell your story. in an episodic series, even a limited series of 7 episodes an hour each, you've got 7 hours. Now you can get into character development and, you know, a whole lot more depth in the story than you would otherwise. So that's the direction we're going in now.
I love just, I want to kind of back up a little bit because you talked about how in the pits, really, in the darker times is when you kind of had another switch and thought of another way to put this thing out. So it could have been very easy, like you said, to just say, let's throw in the towel, we're done. I think people need to hear and know that because that's a lot of times we want to give up and turn our back.
That's the time most people give up. I like to say through adversity comes greatness.
Yes.
During those times, you know, you've got to, you know, it's up to you. Nobody's going to do it for you. But pull up those bootstraps and get to work and you know, focus on positive things and the whole I can attitude that the kids talked about this morning. Perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So where are you guys in this process? Or is it already kind of going in that direction? Have you started the filming part yet?
We haven't started the filming part, but we're gaining momentum right now more so than we have in a while.
It's a big deal.
So there's been a tremendous amount of focus. And you've heard me say this before. Believe in yourself, believe in your mission, believe in your project, believe in a higher power. Put all that belief into whatever it is that you're doing.
Yeah.
And then focus on it. Focus, you know, what is it that you want? What is it that you want to achieve? Focus. Very simple, but difficult in a lot of ways. And then take action in that regard. Whatever it is that you want, what can you do today? What can you do when you wake up? What can you do every day to forward that cause? And it's 3 simple words, believe, focus, and action.
I love it. Believe, focus, and action. And Jack, you're somebody who really has done a lot using your gifts to help other people, create opportunities, problem solve, selfless acts. I mean, you are just kind of all over the board in terms of using who you are and putting that out into the world. How much mental energy would you say it takes, especially as you're kind of writing this book, releasing this series? How much mental energy and focus does that take from you? Are you just kind of, where do you go to create? Where do you go to get inspired?
I'm very pragmatic in that way. Also as a former painter and artist and a former musician, guitar player, singer, songwriter, and all my endeavors, owning an ad agency, you've got to really put forth your creative side. All of those things, you do kind of get into a zone. And it's kind of like if you try too hard, it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
You got to kind of chill, step back, let it flow.
Have fun.
Just kind of connect with the energy. Have fun. If you don't enjoy the process, you're not going to do it because pain will drive you away. So get comfortable with whatever it is that you want to accomplish, whether it's writing, painting, music, whatever it may be, business, connect with it and then move forth. But if you try to force it too much, a lot of times it just won't happen.
I like that. When you talk about, you know, getting into the energy of, I've done a lot of just diving in self personally lately over the last few years. It's the energy of those things, the fun, the creativity, the music, the laughter. That's where the ideas are birthed. You know, I think we spend a lot of time pedal to the ground and getting stuck in a place and we can't figure out why we're stuck. If you feel stuck, pause, back away, listen to that, right?
Do that and jump into that freezing tub.
Jump
in. And that'll shake it loose.
Wow.
I'm telling you, that was kind of what I was thinking. I kind of needed that at this point in my life to really take it a step further. Even though I've got all these things I talk about that are wonderful, you know, believe, focus, take action, you know, I've got to apply that myself.
Yeah.
And to me, that cold water therapy really helped advance that. So if that makes any sense.
It makes a lot of sense. As a former athlete, I remember we used to have to kind of, we used it for recovery, but not in the tub. We would have to put our foot in a boot if we had an injury, right? So not actually hopping in the tub. So where did your mind go? As you're in this cold water tub for 3 to 6 minutes, where did you go mentally to stay there?
That's a great question because it is very shocking in the beginning. First of all, Bill kind of guides you through and he asked me to pick out a kind of a spirit guide animal. I wear a little grizzly bear necklace, so I just automatically said grizzly bear. And here are 2 grown men in the ice water growling at each other for about a minute. That helped take about a minute away.
Yeah.
And then I had 5 to go. But your mind goes in a place that maybe you haven't been before. Mm-hmm. It was not that uncomfortable. It was really just kind of, you know, realizing, okay, I'm here, I'm going to do this, I'm doing it. When I got out, I couldn't believe it was 6 minutes. Wow. I mean, it really didn't feel like it was that long. I was impressed. So,
what are some of the things that you noticed for yourself after that day experience, and what have you kind of taken with you going forward from that?
I go back to that moment every single time I feel cold water. I haven't talked to Bill about that. I don't know if that's normal, but if I'm if I'm just splashing cold water on my face at the sink to get up, I do a 2 minute cold water blast every shower I take.
Yeah.
You know, and it takes me right back there. So that's great. I've never lost that or let go of that. Yeah. It's with me.
Body keeps the score. It remembers.
And I do deep breathing every day, do some stretching, different things that we had set out for me. Working on the weight loss, kind of had to delay that a little bit because I know myself.
Yeah.
And too many things to focus on is also not good, you know, because you won't give the proper attention to each one. So I've just pushed that down the road a little bit, working on some major stuff for the episodic series coming up in the next few weeks. So,
this is exciting.
Very exciting.
If you guys don't know the name Jack Grossman, remember it. This is exciting stuff because I think your books are based on a true story.
Absolutely.
You got a chance to spend time.
Oh, we were dear friends. And I got to be honest with you here and see all these kids in here earlier on Melissa and Patrick's show. I do a lot of speaking to middle schools, and I believe they were middle schoolers.
Yep.
It's kind of crazy, but when you pick a role model, really put some thought into who your role models are, not just because they got a music video or I saw them in a movie, which doesn't mean they're bad people, but, you know, look into what they do. Mm-hmm. How do they help humanity? How do they, you know, forward the cause? And, Charlene is my role model and my hero. Wow. And somebody even said about the insignificance of a flat tire this morning. You know, when I'm out there, if it's a frosty morning, I'm scraping frost on my windshield with a credit card. My fingers are freezing. I'm going to be late for a meeting. I just kind of think to myself and stop, Jack, look at what Charlene went through. We're talking 2 years alone in the forests of Eastern Poland through brutal winters, being chased at, being shot at, being hunted 24/7, eating stuff that you would never, ever think of eating. Just for the sake of survival, I think I can scrape a little frost off my windshield. And we tend to get excited about flat tires and late for meeting. Folks, keep it all in perspective. Ooh. All right. There are a lot of people that have been through a whole lot worse. So, be tough, you know, toughen up and plow through your fears.
I love it. Yep. Perspective, that is such a big, big word, and you are so right. Keep things in perspective. Yeah, those middle schoolers really kind of set a fire. They're such an inspiration, talking about the things that they can do after going through a year like we've all experienced, never before, but we got through it, and we can. Jack, we have about 2 minutes left, buddy. What do you want the people to know? How can they find you? Where to get the book? What's coming next? Let them know how to connect
with
you.
Well, the book, simply jackgrossman.com. Just go to the website. You'll see all the information there.
Shirt here.
Yep.
Love it,
and
buddy.
Thank you for your Mental Fitness Matter shirt as well.
Absolutely.
Trading t-shirts this morning. and also wilderwellnesscenter.com. Check it out. I'm telling you, folks, for $50, don't miss this opportunity.
That's awesome, buddy.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for all you're doing and all you continue to do. You have really, as you just talked about, what are we doing for humanity? And you are doing that, and you have done that, and you continue to lead in that way. Every time we meet up and get our little coffee fix, it's me, you, and Melissa. It's always such a good time. It's such good energy.
It is.
Surround yourself with positive people.
That's a good one. Absolutely.
You know, get into groups and circles that are pushing things forward and having conversations about how to help others and helping one another. And together, we are stronger.
Oh, much.
We really are.
Much.
So much stronger together. Guys, make sure you check out this book, Child of the Forest. Stay tuned for the episodic series. If you are located in North Carolina, stop by Wilder Wellness Center and taking out Bill and Isha and crew, and the team. Make sure you stop by there. Jack, I appreciate you, my friend.
Thank you. Let's set up our next Ammo Cafe with Melissa.
Can't wait. I want my Mental Fitness Matters community to go out and shine bright like the stars that you are. Make sure you guys are being kind, being positive, being nice, and we will check in with you guys next week.
Awesome.